Exactly.
I was just joking, but he admitted to it. So did he really jack off in the shower?
I haven't had to do that in years. Have you seen my wife?
Yeah, she's actually hot. But at the same time, you're married. Married men don't get it all the time. That's what I heard.
Some.
All right. You're just good like that.
You know.
I worship you, my friend.
All right, you ready for this?
Yes.
Let's do it. All right, here we go. Hey, Prince Magnum, when are you and Burt getting together again? How about now?
Oh, wow. Did you give me a ring?
Easy killer.
Okay.
Hello again, and welcome to the Prince Magnum channel. This is another amazing crossover right here with Big Bad Burt and yours truly, Prince Magnum.
Prince Magnum channel. And I'll just let you know that you have to wire me and buy me first so I get to know you a little better. That's a joke.
I do know how to cook.
I've seen. He does. He cooks close to ravioli. Superb.
All right. Now, right now, simultaneously, Maverick Nation, Burt TV is also being filmed.
And it's been filmed.
And we're basically both right now are synced up together.
You're a little late, Prince Magnum channel. Burt TV's been going on, but you'll catch up.
Don't worry, because eventually, the Burt cam will be turned off and everything else will be exclusive. So, if you're a fan of Burt TV or a member of the Maverick Nation, one way or the other, you're going to have to watch both videos to see what happened.
So, yeah, but we'll film as much as we can.
But yeah, anyhow.
And you'll get to see a sneak preview for you. Hopefully the camera won't go up on mine on Mac because I got more storage.
Mine actually now, I have it set up where I can get up to 4 hours of footage now.
We should do a 4-hour video. Okay. A 4-hour tour.
Princess Faye has already told me that I'll have to come get her from work before too terribly long. They're not. Current events. Let me tell you all what has happened. Let's get everyone caught up. Okay. Now, for those who do not know, I was wrongfully accused of child abuse almost 5 years ago and have been on probation.
Can we go a little further? Why did the detective target you?
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, that's an easy one. I sent my son over to my mom's. And I was due to go to work. And at that time, I worked for Rawlings over in Washington. I worked in the helmet department, making football helmets. As a matter of fact, if you've seen a St. Louis Rams player briefly back in 2012 on a screen in Times Square, New York, if you would have seen him wearing a Rawlings Quantum helmet.
You made it.
I didn't make it, but I was the one who prepped it for the paint that went on it. So you already seen some of my work.
So why did he target you?
We're getting to that. Okay. Basically, it started off where took my son over there, and he had an accident before he was due to wake up. Now, I was already at work, so didn't know what was going on. My brother didn't bother to do anything, but sent him to school basically smelling like urine. So I got a visit from Family Services, and they walked in, and I was listening to the Alex Jones show, and basically told them, this is what happened, go screw yourselves, you know, while listening to the Alex Jones show, and told them they had no right come over and harass me and everything else. From there, unfortunately, I didn't have any camera equipment, and I was naive. I did not know what the police nation that we have now, this day and age.
Oh, I do. I'm there.
Actually,
crooks, criminals.
It's worse in Washington. We're getting to that. From there, this caseworker would set up shop outside my apartment, and anybody and everybody can get listening devices. okay? It is not that hard. You can get CIA quality listening devices. So I was under constant surveillance, okay? By the way, I'd never seen the warrant that allowed that.
Tell it to the judge tomorrow.
We're getting to that. Well, it wouldn't do any good now. It wouldn't do any good now. Anyhow, it gets deeper. It gets deeper. Basically, it was almost like a planet spinning off into orbit. You know, spinning out of its orbit. One in a million shot. Okay? I started working around the new S-100 Rawlings baseball helmets. And in the process of this, I was using an industrial super glue. Now, the way the super glue worked is you had to put a primer on it, then you had to heat it, and then you had to put a glue on it and secure the pad and then heat it up some more.
Okay.
My workstation, which I sat at, I sat on a stool about yay tall, and I looked down on my workstation. So as I'm blasting this heat gun to tack up the glue, basically I have industrial super glue hitting me in the face, which, by the way, on the packaging, it literally says can cause Burt defects in the state of California.
Not a misery.
Oh, I actually would leave work most of the time not knowing where I was at, what I was doing. I had to ask people what I was doing. You know, like, what did I do the last hour? Oh, you were doing the S-100s. Oh. There's 3 weeks of my life I really can't account. So I don't know if I really did or didn't do. I won't, you know, it's one of those things I can't say. But all I know is at the end of 3 weeks of this, which, by the way, I did bring this up to the person who was in charge of that division, you know, I need some sort of respirator, something. And he said, oh, you'll be fine.
Meanwhile, Detective Sykes said you did something.
He says I did something. I was under constant surveillance. Princess Faye says that I was not myself. I don't believe that it even in that frame of mind that I could have been that violent.
What'd you do? So, I mean,
they said I shot my son with a airsoft BB gun.
I can't see you doing that.
See what I mean? Everybody says that. And basically, they told me that after work, I was not to go pick up my son. I was supposed to go directly over to the police station. They hauled me over.
Did Princess Faye say you couldn't not do?
We'll get to that. Actually, they had me in an interrogation room. And there's a camera to that interrogation room. And at one point, Detective Steve Sykes actually comes in and threatens that if I don't give a confession, that he was going to shoot. And basically, he said, you will give a confession, full time tapping on his pistol. And I looked at him and said, if you're going to threaten me with that thing, you better skin that smoke wagon. But the moment you do, you have put my life in danger, and I am within my lawful rights to protect myself,
yes,
police officer or not.
Yes, you are, by Missouri state law.
And I said, and right now, I'm still under the effects of whatever it is from work, because I do not know what is going on. So, you know, basically, I don't know my own strength. You're threatening me, so I can't say I won't do serious harm, is what I basically said. And that is not a threat. That's, at that point, I could not legitimately vouch for what could happen next.
And you're just being honest.
Yeah, I was being honest. You know, I had nothing to hide. And basically, they hauled me back to my own apartment and everything else. And after that, they basically, you know, decided that, oh, yeah, he did it. And at the end of it all, Princess Faye herself was actually told that she was to write out basically what they said was supposed to go on that report, because if not, she was going to jail.
She do it?
She had no choice. I don't blame her one bit. By the way, I still married the woman after that, because she did exactly what she should have done, because she was pregnant with our daughter.
Is she sorry she's done that?
I oftentimes wonder. We don't talk about it.
She's scared you're going to blame her.
I don't blame her.
You need to say that. Tell her. Look at the camera and tell her.
Honey, I don't blame you for this mess at all. She knows I love her. And she knows that I would do anything in the world to make her happy. That's why she has her own series.
You helped her start that?
It was my idea. It was my idea. It's been my baby.
Can I tell everybody so they know how we hooked up?
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, and this won't get edited out?
No.
I saw an In Your Face video. It was like on one of my videos I was watching back, because I wanted to see what I said. I don't normally watch Burt TV. And on the side on YouTube was this guy saying, "In Your Face, Bontier Police." And it was the one with this thumbnail where you're like holding your chain, those sunglasses. You know what I'm about?
I know the one. I think I know. Yeah, I know the one. Yeah.
You did a separate.
No, I was like that.
And you did a part two where the camera's sideways, and you know you can fix that.
Now I know that. But you know, honestly.
Miranda had it sideways. Would that fuck up big time?
I hope no one catches that. Okay. I don't think anybody will.
Okay. But it was sideways, and,
She was using the old phone. Faye was using the old phone, and at that time, when we would load from that phone, it was very difficult to do any editing. And I know I could go back and change that, but for nostalgia purposes, I don't like to go back and mess with those videos at all.
Yeah. Sometimes when you edit on YouTube, you can fuck them up. I did that. The video we did over there, I fucked it up pretty bad. You see that?
I seen that, yeah.
I was trying to fix it a little bit, and I was like, I should have left that alone.
You know.
That's why I don't touch our videos anymore.
But no,
Touch.
Anyhow, what... Basically,
smack me. I deserve to be smacked.
No. I'm a man of peace now. I'm done killing, I think.
You are?
But anyhow.
How did they kill me? It's just smack me.
Man of peace part.
Yeah, that could look bad if you were going to court tomorrow. Now tell them about the court case.
Okay, well, we're getting to all that. Basically, after all that, they threw me in a jail cell in Franklin County. And I got to come down from that industrial super glue, and I listened to my head scream. I would take spells where my head would scream, and I just could not. I would literally just go over to my bunk. I would lay down on it, and
I christened you.
And I would lay down with, you know, with sheets over my head, just trying to drown out any noise.
Was it worse than a migraine?
Imagine if you could, your ears doing a nonstop ringing, and you could make out voices every now and again.
Oh fuck, it's worse than a migraine.
And at the same time, and the voices weren't anybody else's except the ones in my head. And I was hearing things like kill myself and things like that.
It was fucking with your head and your mind.
Yeah. So I was, I basically asked numerous times if they would let me see somebody about it. And every time I was denied. So for 2 months I sat in Franklin County Jail listening to my head scream like this. And, I'd say that falls under cruel and unusual punishment, but I'm not a doctor.
Well, I was in Farmington. They checked my blood sugar, threw me back in the cell, it was like 3-something. Said, you're okay. Besides, we don't care if you live or die. On a misdemeanor. Keep in mind, all my charges down here are bullshit misdemeanors. Not one felony do I have on my record. I can still vote. And I've been bullied by the voluntary police over misdemeanors. See, it's not what I did, it's who I did it to that they're pissed off about.
Well, for me, I actually, you know, there's more to the story, okay? Detective Steve Sykes, about 6 months prior to this whole deal, I actually had to sit him down and explain to him how to find a criminal online. And the criminal was my very own aunt. And we've talked about this.
Yeah.
It was embarrassing to the family. It's like, well, what? The only way I knew how to redeem the entire family is if one of us helped bring her in. By the way, she was never picked up at any time by Washington Police Department.
Yeah, he said, was this his dad's sister or mom's sister?
It was mom's sister. Okay. So, he had no idea what I was explaining to him. Had no clue. This detective is so great that he can't even find a handle on a coffee cup.
You said that before.
The AA clubhouse across from the Washington Police Department police station had actually been broken into. We knew who did it.
You talked about this in videos before.
As a matter of fact, Detective Steve Sykes was also put on this case. We actually had to tell him where to find the guy, and it still took Washington another 2 weeks to pick him up.
But you didn't do a damn thing, and they picked you up right away.
Why is that? There's only two explanations that I can give. Two possibles.
They're crooked as fuck.
Well, why are they crooked as fuck in this case? Let's ask the questions. Remember.
They got pressured by DFS.
That could be. But again, Steve Sykes doesn't do anything. Okay?
It's only the voluntary police.
But he doesn't do anything. So why is it that at this point, he would even do anything with my case? Here are the first two hypotheses. I won't even say they're theory, they're just hypotheses. Okay?
Which is, for you people who are uneducated, in order to have a theory, you have to have a hypothesis to back it up.
Right.
Which is a factual theory in itself, basically. If that makes sense. Country people, you're not going to understand that.
Well,
go back to the hold downs and hoot nannies.
Well, basically, in this case, a hypothesis is an educated guess.
Yeah.
And then, in order to get to an actual theory, in this case, we would have to research. Unfortunately, I want nothing to do with Washington, Missouri. Sorry, guys, that's why I moved away. You'd have your own YouTuber starting to do fairly well. And we're going to get to that in a minute, how well we're talking. But, basically, that's why I left. Okay, I'll tell you how great this detective is. I actually stood in front of him and gave him information on Alcoholics Anonymous, how to find us, and even offered to teach classes on alcoholism, and he didn't even know who I was. So if he's that intelligent, why in the world would he do anything? Now the first two guesses is, right after that, he got a little bit of a promotion after that one. So that is one, he did it for the promotion. That's the first hypothesis. He did get a promotion right after that.
Remember, we're not going to a theory, we're just going to the hypothesis, is the factual statement that backs up the theory.
So
there's no theory in this.
Right, there's no theory.
Scientifically, I understand what he's saying on this.
Right. The next guess.
Hypothesis.
The next educated guess. And this one is going to upset my mom, because now I'm going to expose it. My mom is a woman that got around more than, well, let's just say, thank goodness, she doesn't have as many sticking out of her as she's had stuck in her, if you catch my drift.
Yeah.
She'd look like a porcupine. There, and I know at one point, before all of this,
I think I know where you're going with this.
There was money mentioned from the state on my son.
Uh-huh.
I'm almost wondering if there wasn't a shady deal for the detective to actually push.
But you're saying basically a sexual favor for your mom.
Exactly.
And it's hard to say I understand that. Because she's still your mom. That's where I thought you were getting at.
Yeah. So the thing of it is that is a theory, because mom swears to this day that she was not instrumental in the case. However, she was. We know better. Okay? We know better. Everybody knows. It's in the police report, unless that was falsified. And if that's falsified, well, then the detective needs to start coming clean. Okay? Now let's continue. Now that we've established this, I had to get a public defender, and the public defender looked right at me and said, I would love to fight this case. This would be one heck of a case. Because I know that this detective is dirty, dirty, dirty. Unfortunately, the way it works is a dirty police officer is still a police officer, and a judge is going to believe them over you. True story, bro.
So you have a public defender for tomorrow?
I don't know what to expect yet, but we'll get to that.
Okay.
Part of the conditions was that I was supposed to pay Franklin County X amount of dollars for them holding me.
Restitution.
Yes. For holding me, which I haven't had the money. Because, well, we'll get to that in a second. And I was supposed to complete X amount of hours of community service. Okay? That's it. Now, the money issue, come on, I mean, you know. In the state of Missouri, it is perfectly legal for businesses to discriminate against anybody who has a felon. And not just for little felonies, you know, like the, you know, you shouldn't have done that, we're slapping a felony on you. Oh, this is your third time doing this stupid crap. No, they are allowed to plain Jane discriminate against you. For the record, my certificates as a certified nurse's aide, certified med tech with insulin certification are still active under the Division of Aging here in Missouri.
Did you get fired from bachelor's over this?
Huh?
Did you get fired from bachelor's over this?
No.
Oh.
Basically, I can legitimately work in nursing homes, but no nursing home will hire me because of the fact that I have a felony.
How'd you get on a bachelor's?
Where?
In Festus.
I never worked there.
Oh, I heard you did.
No, I never worked there. So, that is a cold hard fact in Missouri, okay?
So this all happened after you left Social Security. I was in security, after you left nursing.
After I left nursing, after my stroke, and I wanted to go back because I knew that was gonna be the only way I was gonna pay the restitution. And unfortunately, I had to rely on temp agencies, and they did their very best. Which, by the way, the most shocking thing that I'm going to tell you, at one particular place, I was actually fired because I was Native American. Guess who the supervisor, guess what, you're not going to believe this. The supervisor was black.
Really?
Not a joke. I think he was just pissed off because my wife was hotter than his.
She is hot.
She is very attractive.
I mean, I've only seen her videos. I haven't seen her in person, but yeah. I never wanted to say that. I don't want to. You don't tell your best friend, "Hey, your wife's hot."
And to me, that's perfectly okay.
Yeah.
That falls under the category. It's
you're
okay.
Hot too.
Well, you know. But anyhow,
just try to be funny.
So I. That's
not
why.
Funny this way. Funny, ha ha.
That's funny, ha ha. Not funny, queer. Yeah. Anyhow, first time I've been. Anyhow. Basically,
I might be coming out of the closet and you'll never know. I'm joking.
So for 2 years I struggled. And I even had to go into, I actually had to seek out psychiatric treatment for the damages that were done to the head.
Well, see, that's like me. I had a stroke when I was 26. Mm-hmm. And my mom didn't believe that I had a stroke. She tried to tell everybody, oh, he faked it. But they wouldn't have kept me. They wouldn't have said I had a stroke. And I even got the medical records far from the hospital at the time. And first RCF, after getting on Malcolm Bliss for 3 months for being paranoid schizophrenic that my mom told lies about, stalking some bitch I didn't stalk. That was news to me. You know.
I love that.
Yeah, I too.
Don't you love how people know more about your life than you
only
do?
Only two times I was stalking accusations were false. Missy Masson, I'll admit I did do that, but that was done online. It was more or less harassment. I've told people what I did, so tell me that's not really stalking, that's just harassment. Hey, we don't have to worry anymore. It went off.
Anyhow, I think let me double check. I think the spirit cam is still rolling.
And we can continue rogering on. Yes, yes, we are still rolling.
Hand me my phone while you're at it.
Okay.
I'm going to start uploading.
Okay, you go right on it.
While you tell your story.
But anyhow, because of this, I did temp jobs. I worked at worked at a plating factory a couple of times. I worked at numerous jobs, doing the best I could. And at one point, before I moved back this way, when we really started pushing the Prince Magnum channel, I'll tell y'all what was going on at that time. I don't think anybody really knows what exactly was happening. I had actually, I was at work, and I collapsed at work. I couldn't get up. I couldn't breathe. I felt like I was having a heart attack.
Your anxiety?
No. They called the wife. She came and got me, took me to the hospital. And the doctors could not figure out what was going on. They said, we don't have a clue. We know that there's something wrong. I had to do all sorts of stress tests.
You told me about this off record before.
Yeah. And I had to do all these stress tests, and doctors did, I could not, they actually had to put me through the chemical stress test, which sucked. That was horrible.
I've done it. Been there, done it. Done the cardio catheter.
Yeah. And finally, a doctor looked at me and said, it's a vitamin B deficiency.
Yeah, I remember you telling me that.
And I'm like, holy crap. So I had to start eating all these vitamins, and then I was like, you know what? You know, I can't get a solid job. I can't make a living. I can't do anything that I need to do. And I looked at Princess Faye, and I said, baby, let's go home. And in one day's time, we came down here and started setting everything up. I got my job at McDonald's, and I went to work at McDonald's. Right at the beginning of September, 2 years ago, and have been there ever since. They have watched me go through some crazy stuff.
And that's what inspired you to do YouTube?
Huh?
Is that what inspired you to do YouTube?
When my health had turned bad, I was afraid that any and all knowledge that I had was going to fade into obscurity. As a matter of fact, on Princess Faye, because we didn't honestly know if I was going to make it, she wanted me to enjoy some things before, you know, because I said, baby, you just got married to me, and I said, I don't even know if I'm going to make it. Basically, she said, let's go have as much fun as we can. She started hauling me to Six Flags.
That's cool.
Yep. I got to get the, you know, I had to do everything from a wheelchair. because I couldn't walk for very long. But I still would pull myself up long enough to ring a bell just to win her a prize.
That's cool. So she supports you even though you guys have problems.
Of course.
Okay.
And basically got down here and...
That's when you got picked on about the cars?
Got picked on about the cars. Had to fight them. So probation.
How long have you lived in Mount Dare?
About 2 years now.
Oh. I lived there since 2009.
Yeah. Now, before I moved to Washington, I actually lived in the same apartment complex with another gal I was engaged to. Irony, huh?
And Princess Faye was living there too?
No, she was still in Oregon at that time.
Oh.
She hopped a plane and came out here to...
How did you guys meet?
Playing World of Warcraft. Yeah, I know right now there's some nerds who just spackled their tongue.
Oh, we can find us a bride. Mm-hmm. No, you can't, because you're not Prince Magnum. He can play role-playing games and find the woman of his dreams.
And the sad part is that the gal that I was engaged to before Princess Faye was the one who introduced me to the game. That's the irony of it all.
He just had enough experience points because he rolled the dice good enough to get a bride. You can't roll that good.
Forget it. Oh my gosh.
Go back to Dungeons and Dragons and Rifts. Remember, play Twerps, the world's easiest role-playing system. You've heard of that one, haven't you?
I've heard of it. But it gets better. It gets better. Okay, so now we're back here, you know, dealing with stuff with cars, and it was always something. Always something. But I had already started the Prince Magnum channel because we didn't know, and my health was better, and I'm like, you know, let's just keep going. Let's see where this takes us. And every once in a while, the probation officer, well, what have you done as far as doing your community service? I said, well, what can I do?
You've done more for the community than anyone's done.
We're getting to that.
So how long have you been doing YouTube? Since 2014?
Well, my first video, which is ironic, was about 6 years ago.
But how long steadily?
2 years.
So 15.
Yeah. Well, no, I started in 2014, and...
So we've been doing it together. I started virtually be April 10th, 2014. Mm-hmm. I'm going on 3 years.
And I would haul my dinosaur of a laptop computer that my brother, who served in the U.S. Army, bought me, and I would haul that poor thing over to wherever I could get Wi-Fi and do the very best I could to get a video loaded. And oftentimes it would take most of the day to get one video loaded.
I want to point out something that's really cool about our channels. Anyone who says, well, his channel's bigger or my channel's bigger, wrong. You'd be surprised to know they're the same size.
Again, yeah.
They're always, and with even when
now I might pull away briefly, but Burt usually catches back
up.
Still,
even when he pulls away or I pull away, we're still roughly same size.
Yep.
I think that this has helped us doing crossovers. I think our channels are always going to be the same size, and they're only getting bigger.
Well,
because a year ago we never dreamed of having this many subscribers.
Actually, I knew I could do it. It took a fuzz longer than...
I'm at 136.
I'm at 134 last I looked.
See, we're close.
Again, close. But here's the irony of it. Now,
and we were close when we met.
Now, it was just a month ago. I was sitting there in front of this probation officer, and she's ready for retirement, so I'm not even going to bust her chops. You know, she's just ready for retirement. She doesn't want to be messed with. Everything's an inconvenience. She asked again, and I said, you know, it took you this long to get me this information, and I ended up losing it in the old phone, the one that cracked. So I don't know where, you know. And she's like, well, I've got to write a report on this. And I said, well, technically, I have more than done it. Okay. And I think Burt will agree with this one. Okay. Here are the following things in the last 2 years that the Prince Magnum channel has done.
Did you tell her?
I told her, and it's all documented on YouTube. And she said, well, it doesn't fall under state of Missouri. I said, so basically what you're really trying to say is I have to do manual labor in a demeaning fashion which no one will see and no one will care about because I'm the lowest form of scum to you.
What'd she say? Yeah.
And she kind of looked at me like, no one has ever just put it that way. And I said, I get it. I said, I get it. I said, don't worry, I understand. But here's what the Prince Magnum channel has done. And right now, I imagine there's a lot of people who are going to be outraged saying, no, he more than covered his 100 hours.
Yeah.
Which even if this is a no big deal sort of thing, I think it's safe to say that... I think it's safe to say if I'm okay after tomorrow and I come home, I'm going to still continue to do this, okay? But let's start off with it. I have done, when we had Project Beauty, I did one car show with her at the Frank Clay High School, and it was to raise money for their music department. When we got Project Spirit, one of the second car show I was at was a car show called The Cruise In for the Blind. And I think a lot of people have seen that. We did a lot of work, built that up, did everything we could, showed up there. And basically a few people on Facebook actually put the information out, even Princess Faye herself, telling everybody that a YouTuber was going to be there. And the people at The Cruise In for the Blind actually said that they could not believe the amount of people that actually came out to donate. This was like huge. So basically with one video, I was there for probably 4 hours that day. And that doesn't include the work that I did beforehand preparing for this. We were able to double what the foundation was able to, what they believed they would have normally taken in on a day like that. I did, you know, I brought awareness to the community at the problems and basically was able to help City Hall kind of straighten up their act. Which now, I mean, it's better, but it's still got a long ways to go. Which brings us to another one. I have quietly been working on a plan of action for the city to help raise money to repave certain streets and to help our water supply issue. I actually have actual plans and ordinances that will actually help that raise money and keep less people out of the courtroom, which is amazing. I was able to sit down and think most of this stuff up in like 10 minutes. I'm not completed with that plan, Bontaire. I'm sorry. There's a few details I have to work out.
Get rid of Doug Calvert.
Actually, Doug was the one that when I told him some of the ideas that I had, he's like, why aren't you on the city council? I said, I've got a felony. And he's like, oh, God. He said, that they'll vote for you. They'll vote for you.
Is it Crooked Town? The cops are crooked. Why can't he work for Crooked Town?
But it's from there.
Calvert's crooked. Sorry, I can't resist.
I know it. But anyhow, from there. I've done the car show at Frank Clay again. I have, let's see, gosh, there's so many things. The whole thing for the police office, well, no, for the military overseas. The Juicy J Pokemon Go challenge,
yeah.
In which I went around, actually walked the city streets themselves for up to 2 hours collecting aluminum cans, which that money went back to help fund the items that went overseas to our troops. Gosh dang.
You know the biggest thing, and this is the personal one you did for me?
What's that?
When everyone was against me, you kind of let them know, hey, this is the situation, this is the story. If you were in the situation he was, you probably would have done the same thing.
And let's not forget the morale boosting that I have done for people within the fast food community, actually bringing awareness that these are people too.
I can't resist saying this. I see that, and my first reaction is, why do you kiss your ass? I just think that. I'm sorry, that's what I think. It was like kissing ass.
It wasn't. What it was, the first one that I did about my job was the fact that I think everybody knows, you know, where Prince Magnum works. And, you know, if this all goes okay tomorrow,
you'll be back at work.
I will be back Tuesday morning, bright early, cleaning out the fry vats so you can all have the best fried foods you can ever imagine. I'll be sitting there cleaning the frappe machine plus the McCafe machine so you don't have to worry about the next time you order a smoothie if it's going to be safe to drink.
And if he's not back and they put him in jail, boycott the Farmington McDonald's.
No, don't do that.
Well, then Steph, they'll get you out of jail. They'll be like, we need you back.
No. The best thing to do is, well, we'll get to all of that. And from there...
Public awareness is the best thing, and that's what we're doing.
Yeah, this is just, you know, this can happen to anybody. Now, at this point, you figure, well, your channel has done a lot of good, Prince Magnum. Why in the world, now, would they even care?
Because of one video. One freaking video. I had changed the word I was going to say. One freaking video. I know which one it is. He knows which one it is. Do you know? I'm going to say for you which one it is. Go back to his channel and watch a video. I don't remember exactly the name, but it has something to do with my true motives.
No, no. Actually, that one did not get as much attention as I thought it would.
Which one was it?
I think that one scared a few people. Nope, the walk around spirit.
You told me about that.
Because right after that, I got the paperwork saying that I had to show up.
Oh, I know what you...
Yep.
I know what was in that car.
Yep.
You should have never done that, man. You know the government was trying to recall that shit.
They didn't want it. They didn't want it.
Shut the fuck up, Burt. Shut the fuck up. I know what's in that car. Shut the fuck up, Burt.
It's what it is.
You had one that they let go.
That they didn't find the carburetor.
Yep.
And I knew full well. I'm going to tell you.
I'm going to smack you so hard, man.
I knew.
And this one I'm going to smack you hard where it hurts.
I knew full well the moment I said it. I just put a big target. You can see the Prince Magnum, the Team Magnum hat. You see the, anyhow, I knew that. I also knew that if they went back through the videos, they would know full well.
Have they approached you about it?
They've actually showed up at my job.
Really?
They were checking out, they were scoping out the security system. They scoped out the security system, wondering if they could kill me at work.
And you know it was them.
Yep. Basically, they had the manager scared. She won't fully, she said, oh, it was such as, yeah, right. They wanted to know my schedule and everything else.
And she wouldn't tell them?
Well, she kind of had to because she's in a spot herself.
So these are government agents?
I'm pretty sure of it. I'm going to do
some. And the True Motives video did not help out much.
No, no. Because I openly admitted that I was trying to deal with Russia on technology, basically.
Yuri at the government, at the Russian agents at embassy is a good, nice guy.
He really was.
You should!
And I was basically, and as of right now, it is official here on the Prince Magnum channel. It won't be official on Burt TV.
But proof I watch is the way he puts up, because I'm putting two and two together now. I love this man, but I want to beat the fuck out of him right now for his own good.
I'm going to openly say,
but you know what? He's beating himself up right now, so it's...
The truth of it is, Burt, and I know a lot of people right now...
You can't beat a good man down when he's beating himself down.
No, I couldn't take it any longer. I couldn't take it any longer. I know a lot of people are asking why.
Yeah, why?
Because I know...
Did you know beforehand, before you showed the carburetor, what you were getting yourself into?
I knew exactly what I was looking at. The secret to carburetor technology has always been.
And you didn't point it out, but they just glanced at it.
They knew. It's one of the originals. And I'm just going to say, as a matter of fact, they really got upset when I was trying to contact the Chinese embassy, too.
Yeah.
Because China has no problem whatsoever doing knockoffs. Shenzhou, I think, is how it's pronounced, which means mountain stronghold.
Right now, there's a Chinese clone of Burt Wurttemberg in China. They knocked me off. I don't know why. I mean,
and I'm pretty sure Xi Jinping is going to be really pissed to know that right now, I, Prince Magnum, am declaring myself as a political prisoner of the United States for knowledge on fuel-efficient carburetors that, in some cases, even on performance V8s that can get up to 34 miles to the gallon, and on non-high performance six cylinders and V8s upwards around 50 to 60. Holy shit.
Yeah.
On top of that, I also know how to take and with a screwdriver and a combination wrench to turn them over to run off of white lightning moonshine, effectively making gasoline obsolete around the world, meaning that the Middle East will no longer be unstable because of gasoline.
OPEC. And basically he was going to say this in January, but he held off saying this stuff. Now he's forced to. And you know what you know how to do?
Mm.
Real well. Dig your own grave.
Yep. And I'm pretty sure Xi Jinping is going to be pissed off to know that I tried to contact his people at the Chinese embassies and they didn't answer the phone. He's probably going to be really pissed. Because this technology could have effectively put China over the top. And I was denying this technology to the United States, this information to the rest of the United States because of my treatment here. And I was going to then, at a later date, offer it as a way to stop the Standing Rock protests. As a matter of fact, yesterday I even tried to contact the Standing Rock Sioux Tribe.
Reservation?
Yep.
I kept up with that for a while.
And I was going to give them that because I know eventually our government will go back.
That's pretty much basically what he's talking about. Standing Rock is in dispute about part of a reservation that we gave to the Indians. I hate saying that, Native Americans. They're Indians because Columbus was in India.
He was an idiot.
Yeah. Because you're Native American, you're not really Indian.
That don't bother me either.
And I got to tell Linda that because she, my ex-girlfriend, she says Indian like, argh! But part of that reservation was taken back by the white man. But their graves are on there. It's sacred ground. You know what I'm saying?
Blah, blah, blah.
And so far I'm accurate. And they're also worried about, in order to frack for oil, you have to contaminate water, aquifers, wells. And by 2030, scientists say that we're going to be in basically a shit creek battle about clean water. That's only 13 years away.
Which is why I came up, I figured out this I put these two technologies
basically
together.
Basically, scientists are saying we're going to run out of clean water to drink. Now, they can turn salt water, ocean water, into clean water. How do you get paid for it? It's very expensive.
Actually, I did some of my own research.
And this goes on to something where Chris Bannon and I disagree on. Global warming, climate change.
I'm not so much worried about global warming. I'm worried about what we call global dimming.
You told me about that. But let me get on Standing Rock and I'll let you say that. Standing Rock basically is saying that, well, you're contaminating water. They want to put a pipeline in. And also the XL pipeline, Keystone pipeline, may be back on again. Because dumbass Trump signed a fucking executive order with review, which review means if we do this, you're in Trans-Canada, you're not going to give it to China, you use it here, and it's tar sands oil, it's contamination, contaminated oil, and as James Hansen of the NASA has said, if we do this, it's game over, because climate change and global warming. And,
well, you'll be happy to know that the technology that I know of, believe it or not, what I know is still in its infancy. Remember the guy who came up with the fuel vapor technology back in 79?
Uh-huh.
Of course, we know he's also dead. Great job, U.S. government. Anyhow, if what he knew about fuel vapor technology was applied to the same system, alcohol could actually power us for many years. Alcohol could power us. I know it's ironic that an alcoholic would say that.
Yeah, and alcohol is actually biodegradable. It's good for the earth.
Well, it's biodegradable. It leaves very few emissions. And on top of that, you don't have to worry about using the water vapor technology, because what the water vapor technology did was that, and I actually looked at this, it separated the hydrogen from the oxygen and it burned the hydrogen. Well, the water that we have here now is what has been here since the beginning of time. We don't get new water. It's not created.
It's recycled.
It's recycled.
I know that from working MSD and Lime. You know,
so
what I'm talking about on Broadway and Hoffmeyer. I was janitorial. You know, we were hired by MERS Goodwill. We had to go through their orientation. And basically, we were their actual employee. And we were told, don't drink water from this fountain. It's on the press floor. And the plant on Lime and St. Louis County MSD. They said, this is what's going back to the community, and everybody thinks we clean it real good and purify it real good. We don't. We just take as much, let's just say, shit out and recycle back to the community.
Mm-hmm.
It's no cleaner than Bonterra water. It just don't have the chlorine like Bonterra water. And I know, because when they disintegrate the shit, when the lights went off on the press floor, we had to get out of there. They were disintegrating the shit. As janitors, we had to clean that shit up. And I will say this, at risk of you editing it out, but it's going to be funny, you'll laugh. I think they'll laugh.
Okay.
It smelled so bad at the MSD plant. It was kind of like eating pussy. Once you get past the smell, you're okay. You leave that in?
Yeah, I'll leave it in. Little character. But no, it's one of those things. I mean, so basically, that's what it is, and I'm declaring myself as a political prisoner of the United States at this point. And we know what's proved, you know, what they're going to try to do. Basically, they're going to try to shut me up. They'll revoke my my probation. They will throw me in a jail cell. They will make me disappear eventually. And the technology will be lost. I don't know if that's what they think.
I don't think so. You know why?
Why?
Because a lot of people probably don't know this. I've been turning my life over to Christ. And before we filmed,
I know, we said a big prayer. And I'm pagan.
Just goes
to show that pagans and Christians can get along just fine.
So I think God's got his back. I hope. I think. Yeah, I think he does. There's always that fear there, because you know God's got his back, but the emotion is there and that fear is there.
Oh, I'm not going to lie. I'm scared to death.
I'm scared now, too, and even though we pray, it's hard to have faith and because of that fear. But if it all works out, we're like about 2 years ago, wow, we were worried about nothing, but it really wasn't nothing.
You know, and see, the craziest thing is that I never knew when I started the Prince Magnum channel that I was ever going to get this deep.
You know what? The reason that I have been able to not be put locked up in jail by the Crooked House of Bonterra is because of Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior. He's had my back the whole time, even when I was worried. I believe with faith, he's got his back too.
Well, I believe that I don't believe any God in any universe would let this happen to someone who's just trying to save a few lives.
My God's got you back.
You know,
because he's still created. Because he created you.
If this works and this technology was able to hit the world, there's no more instability in the Middle East. No more people have to die.
and OPEC would be fucked.
Maybe that's what needs to happen. They've got enough money now. I mean,
Saudi Arabia does, but the other countries really don't. And Saudi Arabia kind of controls OPEC, which OPEC stands for Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries.
Uh-huh.
And OPEC basically is run by Saudi Arabia. They're the richest Saudi Arabia country because they're from Nicaragua, Venezuela, Kuwait, Iran, Iraq. They're not as rich as Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia is making chump change off OPEC. They have other things they're making more money on. I don't know what, but they are.
And the truth be told, honestly and truthfully, I have looked at the history of the Middle East, and even without that cash crop, they'll do just fine.
Yeah.
They always have. And I hate it how, you know, and I don't get on this whole lot, but the Muslim, the good Muslim people, not the militant SOBs that are put in power by the Obama administration. We're talking the real ones, the ones that I've had the opportunity to rub elbows with.
And they get bad names. And I want to say for the record, putting a Muslim ban in this country is not going to work. The real terrorists that we need to watch out for, and he knows this, are white people, our friends and neighbors. They go to our church. They go to our schools. Their kids go to our schools. It's called homegrown terrorists. And you don't know who they are. Because they blend in with the rest of us. Until it's too late. Those are the ones you gotta worry about.
Actually, the real threat is
our government.
Well, I think right now President Trump has a real tough time. Because what you're seeing...
Your president, not mine.
What we're seeing is
I don't recognize him as my... or acknowledge him as my president.
Was he not voted?
Not by me. I don't acknowledge him as a president. That's my choice.
Still popular vote. Pretty sad when Hillary Clinton couldn't even win a rigged election. Anyhow!
Putin rigged it for Trump. We're never going to see eye to eye on this.
I know it. But anyhow, right now he's got a tough job. And I'm hoping he sees this
all
video.
All he does is goes on Twitter and just tweets. Oh, you've seen this video? Fuck you, Trump. Up your ass with a dildo.
But if he does see this video, he knows that there is a chance that the country could... This could sustain the country. It would be big for business. It would bring a lot of jobs back home. And it would stop the need for foreign oil. It would stop the need for oil, period. No more Standing Rock. No more people having their head taken off because they don't want a pipeline going through. And that's basically...
It would change life as we know it.
If you think about it for a moment, a man wrongly accused of child abuse...
Could change the world.
Wrongly accused of child abuse...
Could change the world.
Not just that. How many lives do you think I'd say?
The Prince Magnum channel rocks.
I don't have a clue. Names and faces I'll never get to see.
No, because God's got you back. You're going to get through this.
And
I believe it.
But just to prove my point, friends of the Prince Magnum channel, the Maverick Nation, friends of Burt TV.
Yeah, because I put in my video while I was doing, went listening to him and doing my video uploading, which is uploading. I said for Burt TV audience, Prince Magnum needs your help. Read description. And I put briefly put the situation.
Okay.
I want Burt TV audience to support this man. He's a Burt TV. He's a Burt head like you are. He's subscribed also. Jimmy Buffett has a pair of heads. Grateful Dead has the dead heads. I have the bird heads. You're a bird head.
I can live with that. Okay. To prove my point that the government will never silence a guy like me.
I love bird head. Bird head people, bird TV people, listen. Go ahead.
No one can truly silence me. This is media regardless.
And it's still on YouTube and it always will be.
Quarter turn, quarter turn, quarter turn. I see you looking at me weird.
Yeah.
Retard the spark advance 1/4 turn.
Oh, you're telling what to do.
Retard your spark advance 1/4 turn. Turn down, turn in. Basically, cutting some of the fuel. 1/4 turn on your carburetor. If it's a 4-barrel, that's where the 2/4 turn is. That'll get you close enough to run White Lightning Moonshine. You may have to remove the thermostat because alcohol burns very hot. Do not use aluminum heads. Aluminum intake is okay. Headers are just fine. Forged crank, 4-bolt main preferably. Forged pistons, connecting rods. You could pretty well do whatever you want, but make sure that they're forged and make sure that your engine is balanced as much as possible. Sit back and enjoy the ride. And if you rebuild your carburetor, please get from a reputable source and take it to your local carburetor guru and let him tinker with it. 64 miles to the gallon is obtainable.
Well, now you couldn't silence them. Secret's out.
And it's available for anyone now. Make sure that the body on the carburetor is 100% straight. Any carburetor from the 1970s can obtain the fuel economy now. Because the problem was, only certain ones could, because we were crap at precision parts. And if anybody knows carburetors, the precision parts that make the carburetors work, we were crap at building in this, even as far back as the 60s.
But from what he's told me, somewhere along the line, we got it right.
Mm-hmm.
We got the precision right. They want those carburetors, the ones that were done right.
And
he's got the carburetor on his car. They saw it. It was done right.
Mm-hmm.
The government recalled all those. Literally took them off the cars. Said, we want these carburetors. We're taking them.
Mm-hmm.
They were done right. Haha, I have some of this knowledge too. Bitch.
And this is my third one. But today, the precision technology exists. You just have to get the right rebuild kit. So that means all of them can be fuel efficient carburetors. Start beating your local junkyards and start looking at some of the old gearhead garages around your neighborhood. I promise you, you'll find one.
You should tell them what carburetors to look for.
Oh, that's easy. Any and all Carter one barrel carburetors from Ford inline sixes, any and all of them from the 1970s will suffice today. Any and all, pretty much all of your 2-barrels will suffice today, provided that the jets are small, not the big ones, the small ones. Pretty much, I believe, Chrysler was still using, the Chrysler Corporation was still using, ones from the Rochester plant. Any and all Rochester Quadrajet 4-barrels will do, provided that the jets up front are small. Do not get the ones that are the same size as the ones in the back. There's also a neat little trick that you could do that turns it over where the back four will only run on vacuum. By removing one rod, I just don't remember. I didn't see it until I was like, you know, the last time I seen it, I was 18.
My advice to you before you leave here, upload on my Wi-Fi. This is just because if you wait too long, you might not get the chance.
I know.
I would upload as soon as we get done with this on my Wi-Fi.
But that'll get you your start. Also, while you're at it, do me a favor. If you're rebuilding this engine from the ground up, keep your compression ratio at about 8.5 to 1. That'll be more than enough. On a system like this, the horsepower numbers won't be very high, but the performance will be there. And just build on, as usual, on the outside of the engine. You'll be in the ballpark. Well, dang it, that pretty well covered it.
Okay, try to upload this here. So let's upload it. Don't even edit it. It's too important, Prince, to get this out. You may not have the chance if you go home and upload it.
You're probably right. Yes, we're that scared. I, Prince Magnum, citizen of St. Francis County, half Native American, descendant of the Pima Indians, am now declaring myself a political prisoner of the United States. Any country willing to let me help them bring fuel-efficient technology without gasoline to their country, now would be the time.
I'm just an innocent bystander, just like the viewers.
Yep.
I'm hearing for the first time. Not all of it, but a lot of it.
It's hard being as smart as I am. A lot of people can't even believe.
Damn it, Prince Magnum, why are you so smart? Too smart for your own good.
I guess it was just meant to be that way.
We're going to get through this. As a Burt TV, Prince Magnum channels, me, him, we're all going to get through this. Because we can't lose him. He's too valuable to us.
I'd like to think that I'm a national treasure that hadn't been discovered until now.
And I've already lost too many friends to death. I'm not losing this one.
Because you know that's what they're going to do.
Yep.
They're going to kill me. But they're going to put me in a jail cell, and they're going to find an excuse to kill me.
That's why we need to upload this video as soon as possible. Try to, because this is the only safety net you have.
I know.
So let's end it here and start uploading.
Sounds like a great idea. Any final thoughts?
You should end it the way you normally do, about sweep them off your feet and all that stuff.
Yeah.
Right here. Show the people you're still the Prince Brandon we love. Say it! End it the way you do.
Well, if we're going to do it, we're going to do it as I've done so many times.
I'm going to put sunglasses on. We're twins. Long hair. Not as long as his sunglasses.
For all of you out there who now have a deeper understanding of me, Prince Magnum, a man that has been persecuted, even for the people that will be doing the persecuting.
Because he's a loving man and forgiving. Remember that.
No matter what. No matter what, for all of us. Even if they silence my voice, they will never, ever silence my spirit.
Or his heart.
That brings us to the end of this episode of In Your Face. As always, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Now more than ever. Get out there and work on a project. Now you have one to work on. If you have a sweetheart, sweep them off their feet, because there may be a day you might be giving them one last kiss goodbye. And as always, if nobody has told any of you that they love you today, Prince Magnum does. God bless you, and have a happy 24. Thank you.
And when you turn off the camera, I'm going to suggest something. Might be quicker. Well, turn off the camera.
Turn off the camera, okay.
Yeah. I got an idea.
Wow.
What?